I thought I'd just bring you up to one of my favourite spots on the farm, up here with the lovely Hoitzer, at one of the most beautiful viewpoints on the farm. We are so, so lucky here. But I just really wanted to give you a little bit of video. I'm just going to pop this down over here so I can talk to you. Because what I've done today is I've put lots of very random clips together. Which is going to eat the camera now. Because every day we take so many videos and pictures of all the horses that we've for years shared on our Facebook behind the scenes page. And various other social media, like I said in my video before, where I was giving you an introduction to everybody. So what we've done this week, because we've had a fantastic week, Hoyts is going to disappear now, he doesn't want to talk to me anymore. We've had a fantastic week with some lovely visitors, all sorts of things going on. The weather's not been great, it's beautiful now. Hoyts is doing his usual scratching his legs because he wants me to itch them. But yeah, I've put all these bits of video together that we've taken during the week. So I'm really hoping that you're going to enjoy this. And it's a little bit random, but they're the random things that we usually share on our Friesian Experience behind the scenes Facebook group. So do check this out. It's quite a long video, but it's just a little taster of some of the things we've been getting up to this week. It's just a little bit of it. That I really hope you enjoy. It's always different here every day. You're trying to eat my jacket. You know, there's always so much going on, and we've always loved sharing with all our followers, whether you're coming here to the farm or whether you're following us online. So this is just a little bit for all you wonderful people who started following us on YouTube to enjoy about all the boys and girls that we've got here. So this is, of course, the lovely Hoitzer, 20-year-old Hoitzer, who's my big old thug, aren't you? So he's out here tonight with little JB, who you'll have seen in the video that I share, him having his clip today. So he's up there enjoying some tasty grass. So yeah, I'll stop waffling now, which is what I'm very good at, and let you carry on and enjoy the video. And thank you again for watching. As I said in the introduction, it's been a busy old week, but most of our days do start out with a little bit of this, a little bit of mucking out, horses going on and off the walker if they've been in overnight. So here we've got Anya coming off the walker. They tend to go on for about half an hour, followed closely behind by the lovely Doubtson. Once all the horses were sorted, we had our first visitors of the week, which was Ali and her family, who came along for one of our Meet the Horses tours. Now, Ali's mum isn't too steady on her feet, so what we did was we brought a number of the horses up to the yard so that they could meet everybody, learn a little bit about their backgrounds, what they're doing with us, how they arrived at the farm in the first place. So they also watched a little bit of Jodie working with Ice, me working with Bear, headed into our beautiful friendship barn. So there they are with Ice. We also had a little sneaky stand under the infrared solarium because it's lovely and warm, very therapeutic for both horses and people alike. Ali's husband Charles got these beautiful photos for us, including this great one of the quotes that we have inside the barn. So when you're sitting in there, we have different quotes over the walls. You can sit and relax. As you can see here, we were doing that while we had a nice cup of espresso and had a good old chat. So I thought I'd give you a little insight into our day today. So we've got a beautiful sunny day here in Cartmel. This is Anya. Anya's just had her bath, which you're going to see on this video, slightly speeded up. So we've got a lovely family coming up from London to spend some time with us. It's their daughter's birthday, so they're coming and having a carriage drive with us in the village later today. They're then going to go for a bite to eat in the village because we've got some amazing restaurants down there. And then they're going to come and spend a night in our stable stays. So we're going to take Anya for the drive, so that's why it was very important that she has a bath. because we always like to be nicely presented for that. So Annie's had her bath and Holly's out at the moment taking Hunnis out for a drive, because Hunnis will be going into stable stays with them for the night. So they're going to spend a night with him, and then tomorrow she's going to spend the morning with us on the yard on one of our yard experiences, and probably have a sit on one of the Friesians after Jodie's worked them. So that's a little update on what we're doing today. So after Annie's had her bath, I'll just make sure I brush through her mane and tail so that they dry nice and floaty for when we go out in the carriage. So by brushing through it, it means that it dries not in clumps, and it dries with the hairs all separated, which I always think looks a little bit nicer. Hey, little gilly. So as it's a little bit chilly today, what I've done after Annie's bath is I've just popped her into our friendship barn here so she can stand underneath the lovely solarium while she dries out. Can't you, darling? And then you can join your buddies back out in the turnout before we go out driving later. So I love it under here because we don't tie them under the solarium, so she can choose what part of her body she wants to put under here. And we've got lots of lovely heat, helps her dry out, and is also great for her skin and her coat. And that she loves her scratchies. She loves her scratchies, don't you, darling? Mm-hmm. She is a nice mum. She is a nice mum. All the Friesians love their pampering, but Anna in particular loves cuddles and scratches, especially when she's in here, especially round her neck and all over her mane. Don't you, darling? Yeah? She's a good girl. Yeah? She's a good girl.
So Annie's had a little bit of time, as you saw, under the solarium, and now she's come out to join her buddies, Doubts and her favourite girl, out in the turnout in the sunshine just to finish off drying and have something nice to munch on. Also got the lovely Nika out here at the moment. So Nika's just having a little bit of time in because unfortunately she just slightly strained one of her legs a couple of weeks ago. So she's just having a little bit of rest time. And if you're lucky, Anya will let you go near the food for a little bit, if you're very lucky. But she doesn't often like to share. So here's our handsome boy, Hunnis, who's just had a nice little amble and little trot round the lanes with Holster, with Holly, just because he's going to be heading into stable stays tonight. So because he's quite an active-minded horse, it's always nice for him to do a little bit of work before he goes in there. How was he, Hol?
He was good. Yeah, we've just been doing quite a bit of work recently and getting him just to loosen off and let go a bit. He's not there yet, but he's definitely better than he was.
So he's got quite tight in his neck. He's got various issues with his joints and his feet. So he's quite a tight, tense little horse. So Holly's been doing a lot of work with loosening him off, especially through his neck and his shoulders. But anyway, he's had a nice little trip out today and now Holly's gonna give him a bath. Stood over here next to Hunnis is the lovely Doubtson. You'll have seen on that intro video, Doubtson in her yellow. Sorry, she's got the wrong coloured rug on today. But Doubtson is renowned for always doing loads of droppings. So she comes and stands at the tie-up point and she has to do a dropping or two or three or four. And she's also very well renowned with my trainer because when we go to Mel's, Mel has to spend half the session picking up her droppings. But I always look at the positive and think at least everything's working properly and everything's flowing, isn't it, Dale? Eh? So we're gonna do a little bit of work with her today. So a little bit of schooling in the arena. Look at that beautiful face.
With the horses all worked through the day, everything prepared, it was time to get Anya ready for her early evening drive in the village with our visitors from New Jersey. So the carriage you can see there was all prepped Anya in her beautiful peacock blue colours, her lemur bandages and her pad. She's all dressed and ready in her harness. That black on the floor there is from the hoof black we put on her feet to make her look extra pretty. As we headed down the road, down past Ainson Manor Hotel, we were greeted by all the cows in one of the local fields who decided to run along beside us, which was lovely. But Anya's great, she's not fazed by anything, so she just carried on trotting along the road. We met up with Regina, Alex, and their very excited 10-year-old daughter, Marielle, in the village to take them for a little tour round. We went through the woods and across one of the fields, across the Cartmel race course and back into the village. And on our way back, because it had just started to drizzle slightly, we were met with this very, very beautiful full rainbow that you can see here, shining just above where some of the other girls and boys were out in the field grazing. And as we headed back down to the farm, we even got this lovely picture of the full rainbow over Anya's head. Once Anya was all cleaned up and tucked up in bed, it was time for Hannes to head down into stable stays. Whilst Regina, Alex and Marielle enjoyed some dinner down in the village, it was only right that Hannes tucked into his tea as well, while we waited for them to head back. One of my favourite things about stable stays is the fact that a lot of people who come along have kept it as a surprise for those visiting, and I knew that Marielle knew nothing about the fact that she was coming to spend the night with one of the horses.
Oh, wow. Wow.
So cute. Hi. He has such a nice bedroom.
What's his name?
He's called Hannes.
Hannes?
Hannes. Hannes.
Hannes.
Now, he's quite cheeky. He's quite cheeky, but he's got the coolest bedroom on the farm. Do you know why it's the coolest bedroom on the farm? Look behind you.
Oh, there's a bunk bed.
Do you want to stay here maybe, Maria?
Yeah.
So, this is the only place in the world where you can come and sleep in a bed like this.
That's so
next
cool.
to one of these.
Are you excited, Maria?
Yeah.
So, if you look behind you at that top bunk bed, can you see that it's open up there?
Uh-huh, you can see.
So,
he could come.
He can come and chat to you. Now, because I know you've got horses, and I know you're confident with horses, I've given you probably one of my cheekiest friends. Okay?
You're big.
Now, he is renowned for pulling covers off in the middle of the night. So I can't guarantee that any of you are going to get a good night's sleep, I'm afraid.
So my wife does the same thing. It's pretty much I'll have it from both sides.
So it's really important that there's one really, really strict thing that I say with him, because he is so cheeky. Do not give him any treats. At all.
It makes him worse. Our horse is like that.
Yeah, because he will, so that I warn you, he will stand there in the middle of the night, he'll kick the partition, and he'll demand attention. Okay? So feel free to tell him off and tell him to go away. It might be that he's run out of haylage, but I'm going to show you where his extra haylage is.
Okay.
Okay. Behind you, you'll see his breakfast.
Yeah.
He thinks that he should get it at about 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock. He's not supposed to have it till 5 o'clock. So ideally, you hold out till 5 o'clock.
Okay.
After a night in the stable with Hannes, Regina had the right idea. She headed down the driveway to look at the beautiful views from the farmhouse with her morning cup of coffee in, of course, one of our Friesian Experience mugs. After a night with Hannes, who doesn't always let you sleep very much in stable stays, we decided that JB would join them in the stable for the night, because he can go in the living side as well, and he's a lot quieter through the night. He certainly doesn't trump as much as Hannes does. So he had to have a very quick bath to make sure that he dried out in time for them going into the stable for the evening.
Mariella has her own Haflinger back at home in the States. She's a very, very capable young lady, even at just 10 years old. She was spending the day with us on one of our yard experiences and started off with going down with Jodie to the field to bring a few of the horses in. She led Bear up from the field, or Vibran, and he's an incredibly sweet, gentle horse. So she took him into the Friendship Barn, where she got to spend a bit of one-to-one time with him, getting to know him, and understandably, she completely fell in love with him. As part of her yard experience as well, her mum wanted her to have a sit on, and you know that, you know, this is quite a limited opportunity that we offer, but we bought Hannes out, who she'd spent the night with, because he's a very, very sensible, very good little horse, and we let her have a hop on and a little gentle ride round the arena after Jodie had finished doing some work with him. Whilst Jodie and Mariella were having fun on the yard with all the horses, doing a bit of grooming, moving horses around, I had Pamela and her husband Alistair. So Pamela was coming along for her second drive experience with me. So this was a Christmas gift that she'd got. So Mabel came out, we got her all harnessed up, and then we went for a drive round the quiet lanes, and Pamela did a fantastic job of driving her once again. She's such a cool little mare, this, and loves her driving. It was then time to get a few horses in and get them cleaned up and groomed and pampered, and as you can see there, Marielle was getting stuck in, grooming and brushing Anya there. We had Doubtson and Renske all prepped and ready to go off for some training in the afternoon with our wonderful trainer, Melanie Turner, who I've been going to for many, many years now. So on this particular day, I was going to be taking Doubtson and having a session with her, and Holly was taking Renske, who you'll see here a little bit in her session. Renske may be 17 years old, but she's a brilliant, brilliant schoolmistress, so it's great for Holly to have the odd lesson on her. As for Doubtson, she continues to teach me to try and be a better rider. She's such an incredible moving horse, not the easiest to ride, but yeah, she's taught me so much over the years. Meanwhile, back at the farm, Marielle was obviously continuing to help Jodie with the horses. She was also getting to know a little bit more about JB and spending a bit of time with him in stable stays. But when I got back, she had a very important question to ask me. She'd clearly absolutely fallen in love with Vibran on her day with us. So I made the exception and I let her have him in stable stays for the night. This was his first night in there, but I was really confident that it was all going to go well. And I let them keep JB and Vibran in for the night, and they had a wonderful time. It was then Regina's turn to have some time with the horses. So Peppa Pig, Mabel, our gorgeous girl Mabel, was out in action, and Regina had a go at doing some carriage driving, which she'd not done before. And again, she did a fantastic job with Mabel, even though the weather wasn't very kind to us.
Come on, Mabel.
Just heading back down to the field with little Mabel, who's been wonderful driving today.
She actually prefers to be out. You're putting your head down against the wind. It's not nice, it's really horrible. Fairly typical like autumn, winter, Lake District weather right now. So yeah, the skies are rather black. The rain is coming down. Let me turn this round so you can see. Mabel coming back out to her very sticky field now, because she really doesn't mind being out in the rain. I'm pleased to say that Bear got through his first night in stable stays, so he did really well. He had Jubbers in with him, which we sometimes do if people are staying for two nights. So that was really lovely. They were great people to give Bear his first introduction. So as Mabel wanders off over there, I'm about to get Hidder in. He's he's going to come and spend a night in. Look at those black skies. Look at those black skies and the rain. But it's that time of year now, and we are in the Lake District. So what do we expect? But Mabel's not rolled in a muddy puddle yet. I'm sure she'll do so before the morning to get herself nice and wet and grubby, as she loves to do. The weather's turned really, really grim outside. And the reason I'm showing you this is Anya, who I've just brought in, and she's had a bit of a leg wash and a tail wash. So she's had a rain sheet on, and I've brought her in under the solarium because she was actually trembling. You can just see all her little rolls of fat just trembling away there. And you see just on the side there. So she was really, really chilly just because there was a sudden drop in the temperature, and she didn't get wet. She had her fly sheet, and not her fly sheet on, her lightweight turnout, but it just shows that sometimes they do really feel it when the weather turns quickly. So this is where I'm so glad that we've got the solarium here, so I'm able to stand her under here and get her muscles and her body nice and warm again. So she's actually heading into stable stays tonight. While Annie's enjoying the luxury of the friendship barn and the solarium, the three boys here, Hannes, Icebrand and Vibran, are out in the rain. But to be honest, most of the horses much prefer to be out rather than inside. It's just that Anya got particularly chilly today. So these three, although they're wet, they're quite happy. So Holly's got so wet today, and you didn't wear your cowboy hat today. So this is, what's the purpose of this?
It's so that my hair doesn't drip onto the board, because otherwise it drips. I've had to take my jacket off because otherwise that drips.
Yeah, and when you're writing on a whiteboard, so this is the greetings for stable stays that we put on every day for every new visitor.
Yeah.
So Holly didn't want her hair to drip on the board.
So I have this towel that smells a bit like cat weed.
Does it?
I don't know, maybe it's just damp, but it smells a bit funny.
It probably like is it. Cat pee.
Oh yeah, at least they never on my jacket.
Feed time for the boys. They're actually being very polite because they're busy standing out of the rain, which is driving horrible and hard right now. So the rain keeps coming, and it turns out all our nice rain sheets that we reproofed, they're the red ones, we reproofed them all. Unfortunately, they're proving to not be waterproof, so I've just had to bring down a thicker rug for poor Micah, who was also trembling because she got so wet and soggy. You know, they do adjust to it, but yeah, it's not nice when the weather changes very suddenly. And they get wet and they get chilly, so it doesn't look like it's easing off anytime soon. So we got soggy rugs, soggy everything right now. Girlies really don't want to go back out. It's just awful. I'm sorry, I don't mean to moan about the weather the whole time, but I don't like it when they're not happy. They're all stood up there, shielding themselves from the driving rain. Yuck, yuck, yuck. Here's three of the lovely beasties this morning. There's Annie there on the right, who's just come out of stable stays, so she doesn't go in there very often. She had a night in there, and she did her job of keeping everyone awake all night with her tromping, didn't you, Annie? But yeah, young girl having her 11th birthday, so she's 11 today. So I think she had a lovely time with Annie, who of course loves lots of cuddles and scratches. And then we've got Niki News in here. She's just, I don't know whether I've mentioned on here, she just still had a little bit of heat in her joint, so we've just rested her for the rest of the week. And then we've got grumpy old man Hida, who's being really mean to the two girls. Look at you pulling faces. Are you in a bad mood this morning, eh? Probably because I made him stay in last night, so we had him in the top barn last night rather than out with his girls. But
we thought we were being nice to him because it was raining and really, really horrible yesterday. But yeah, he's busy bullying the two girls at the moment. And we've got Hol over here giving little jabbers a clip. Which you'll see more of later because Holly's videoing it all. So I'll just give you a little snippet of it for now. So he gets clipped because it takes forever to dry otherwise. And obviously we always like him nice and clean in stable stays. Little Hiddy Hops has had a lovely pamper with Freya. And he's now just chilling in the friendship barn. Aren't you gorgeous boy? Eh? Are you not quite so grumpy now? You're not quite so grumpy. So we'll get him rugged up again. And I think we'll probably pop him out. Pop him out with his girls again for the night. Might actually just try him back in the round pen with these two. Just to see whether he's in a better frame of mind now. But it is a funny time of year, you know, they're changing their coats, the weather's changing every 5 minutes, going from being warm to cold to rainy. So you always get funny things happening around this time. And there's little Jubbers, who has had a complete clip. So I'm not going to let any of you abuse Holly for taking his legs off. We were going to leave his legs fluffy. I have to say, he does look rather gorgeous with them all clipped out. They will grow back. And as Holly quite rightly said, he now matches all the others. So he's got his little snuggly rug on. He's tucking into the haylage there. And he seems a happy boy. Meanwhile, who have we got over there? So we've got Renska down here. Renska's having a little bit of a bath now because she's going to be the next to be clipped. It's, look, of course I'm not getting you in trouble. I have mentioned it on the video, of course, you know. But it's fine because he actually looks lovely and, as you said, he now matches all the others.
Yeah, she...
Hol's going to take his rug off so that you can all see how he looks. So yeah, as I was saying about Renska, so she's just having a bath now because it's much better to clip them when their coats aren't greasy, otherwise it tends to blunt the blades. So she's having a bath, she'll dry out and then she'll be clipped. She's quite a hot horse, so it's better for her to be clipped, otherwise when she's working, when she gets a fluffy coat, she gets quite sweaty and then it takes a while for her to dry out. So little Jubbers rug's coming off. So he obviously had a bath after he was clipped, so that just removes all the loose hairs and stops him getting really itchy. Like, he's not going to stop eating, is he?
No.
Look how gorgeous he looks. Oh, look, little Jubbers. So this is actually the first one that you've clipped fully, ever.
Yeah.
No, you've not.
No.
Look, he's happy. He's not trying to bite you, so that's always a good sign. Look, Hoyts is looking down from up there. Hoyts, you're not getting clipped. You've got the best view in the world up there, haven't you, Hoyts? Best view in the world. Oh, Jubbers is trying to see if I've got anything to eat now. Cheeky boy. You can have your jumper back on now. No, I think he looks great, Hol. So I just wanted to see how Hidda was going to be out with these two. And he still seems a bit grumpy, doesn't he? Eh? Is he just not loving you, Anya? Eh? Is he not loving you? He definitely seemed a bit happier in himself. I suspect that it is just that he wants to go down the road with the rest of his girls. And they're all having their sort of end of season at the moment. So they've all been coming into season this week. And you know, that in itself, all the hormones going round, can make them quite grumpy with each other. But yeah, he's particularly not loving Anya. Wixie's still up the top there looking down on everything. I am going to take you out again, Hidda, because I can't have you beating up on Anya. Nika was literally throwing herself at him the other day because she was in the height of season. So he's obviously loving Nika right now, even though he was bullying her a bit earlier. And he probably just doesn't want Anya coming anywhere near. So Anya's sort of hiding behind me at the moment. But at least he's nuzzling with Nika there. So I don't think it's anything to worry about. I think it is just hormones and seasonal changes. So that's all a good sign. So while I leave those two together, Nika and Hidda, I thought what I'll do is pop Annie out in the other turnout with the little guy. So there's always herd dynamics to keep you guessing. And work out what's best for them all. Very often I leave them to it, you know, they need to work out the hierarchy and what's going on between them. But you know, sometimes you have to intervene, especially if they're in a little small turnout space like this. Then I can't have them bullying each other. Hey, are you going to be nice to the little guy? Yeah, you will be, I'm sure. Well, and Holly's got Rensker all beautifully clipped, but you have to check out Holly's face, because Holly always gets most of the hair all over her face, don't you?
Yeah,
I'm going to zoom it right in just to show quite how much hair you get over your face.
I actually had to wear these because the hair kept on blowing in my eyes.
It's always good never to wear lip gloss as well when you're clipping, isn't it?
I've never worn lip gloss.
Oh, have you not? Okay. Ren's looking very, very beautiful. So she'll still go out tonight, but she'll have a thicker rug on her. But it'll make her a lot more comfortable when she's working. You can see Holly, quite rightly, always plaits up all her hair to make sure that there's no accidents, because it's a little bit windy today. So that means that she doesn't accidentally trim off any of her mane. Has he got his grumpy face on again? So Freya's got Hidda there. And just for anyone who's not sure, you will notice that he obviously does look lame, because he's got a condition called fibrotic myopathy. So he's got some scar tissue within his muscle here, which means that he can't step forward with that hind leg. So he's not in any discomfort, he's not in pain from that, but it is something that obviously affects the way that he walks. And it's one of the reasons, one of the many reasons why he's retired. There's also this big scar down his side, which is from sarcoids that he had many years ago. So, but he lives generally a happy retirement, although as you've seen, he has been a little bit grumpy today. But Freya over here, he's going to pop his rug back on and then take him out back down with his girls. And hopefully he'll be much happier. Your If you've got to the end of the video, thank you very much for watching. I hope this has given you a little bit more of an insight into what we do here at our farm in Cartmel in the Lake District in England. If you've enjoyed it, please do share your views, share your comments with us. And if you've not done so already, please do feel free to hit on that subscribe button and share our videos with anybody else who you think might enjoy them. Thank you again and see you on the next one. I'm under your spell and I'm under your body. Oh, it's like black magic. You work your voodoo on me. Black magic. The things you do to me.